you, Madam Chairman, and I want to thank my colleague from Colorado who has allowed me to use his map to illustrate the issue of rip and replace. Which
Senator Lummis, I've wanted collaboration so much, and I'm glad we have it.
You definitely have it on rip and replace. This is a huge problem for the three states in brown, Nebraska, Wyoming, and Colorado, because the Congress only provided enough money to cover 40% of the costs of eliminating the Chinese-made equipment from their networks. And the three states that are the most at risk are the three in brown, including my own. So one wireless provider in my state is deciding now what parts of their network they'll need to shut down soon. I mean really soon, because they don't have the funds to replace the equipment that Congress ordered them to remove. So this provider covers 122,000 square miles of land. It contains 450 healthcare facilities, 1,900 schools, 40 military installations, a significant part of that includes segments of Interstate 80. Now, I-80 runs, of course, from coast to coast. It runs through central Nebraska and southern Wyoming. The area of coverage that is going to get lost is this area of coverage. And it covers a large part of Interstate 80. So all of those truckers, and it's a huge commercial trucking route across our country, and they're going to lose coverage. And so if we have spectrum, great, but if there's nobody to access the spectrum on the ground, what good is it? So for Wyoming and, of course, my colleagues in Nebraska and Colorado, this is a huge risk, and time's running out. They're going to shrink their coverage because of the huge geographic area that they need to coverage. So I definitely share the goal of identifying additional spectrum for the rollout of 5G and 6G, but truly it won't be much use if no wireless providers are around to use it, because rip and replace was inadequately funded. So I want to make an urgent call, along with my colleagues from Nebraska, Wyoming, and a couple other states, even the ones in the more orangey, the deeper orange, are in tremendous risk of losing coverage. So, and we have funding sources. There's two bills that have funding sources. One is Senator Fisher's from Nebraska, and she's using extra COVID monies. Senator Daines has another source of funding to fully pay for this rip and replace. But the fact that it hasn't been done, and it has put these providers at a place where they're just going to have to cut coverage. And it's been a long time since you could drive down Interstate 80 and just all of a sudden dropped the call for extended mileage before you can pick it back up. And this is critical because our blizzards are epic, and trucks are left by the roadside in a moment's notice when a blizzard hits. And this is dangerous to allow rip and replace to be underfunded. I urgently make the pitch to fund rip and replace, not only for my state, but every other state that did not benefit from the funding that was inadequately provided for rip and replace. So off my soapbox for a few minutes, I would like to ask a question about Open RAN. Ms. Rinaldo. Could you tell me how these advancements in Open RAN contribute to making connectivity more affordable and accessible for rural communities?
Absolutely. I 100% agree. We need to rip Huawei out and have a strong supply chain to ensure this doesn't happen again. So I think that some of the great benefits of Open RAN is the competition. 127 players in the ecosystem is going to help bring prices down. We're also moving to virtualization and software-defined networks, which is going to shrink our footprint and keep things in check. I think bringing AI into the ecosystem is going to help with spectrum efficiency. After you have your radio equipment in place, energy is the next largest cost that the carriers face. So if you're able to do sensing capabilities, will also help bring down costs. And then just innovation. It's going to allow for updates to occur much easier and much simpler, so you don't have to wait for the next 10-year life cycle to occur. So I think there's a lot of excitement, and it's well-deserved.
Thank you. And Madam Chairman, I know I'm out of time, but I may want to submit some additional questions for the record, particularly with regard to Open RAN and concerns that rip and replace causes rationing the remaining parts that they need to repair equipment. And as I said, we're only one bad snowstorm away from the network going down. Hey, thank you all. This has been a wonderful panel. Appreciate you all. Thanks, Madam Chair.
Senator Lummis, do you have a number associated with your region on rip and replace? Do you know?
Yes. These three brown states, the unreimbursed costs are greater than $200 million. Now, on the more orange states, the more vibrant orange, it's between $100 million and $200 million. And there's a number of those as well. And then those that are the more pastel orange, between $10 million and $100 million. So I think it's, what, about $3 billion to fund the whole shebang? And everybody should... they were required to rip it out and to not fund the replacement for these small rural providers. Just puts them out of business.
Well, how does this affect your technology development? You know, part of CHIPS and Science with the EPSCoR legislation was trying to unfold more places, because you can't just do all the technology in very expensive places. So we want to unfold more technology. So how does that affect your ability to attract some of these technology companies with your additional EPSCoR funding?
Yeah, as you can imagine, it's absolutely huge. Now, we have dark fiber that was put across southern Wyoming, kind of along the I-80 corridor some years ago. Some of it is still dark simply because the technology needs to be built to utilize that capability. But again, without rip and replace, we're struggling to provide the important components of a fully integrated system. I want to add one more thing, since you've been so kind to ask this question. In Cheyenne, there's kind of a lead development of standards in the architecture. It's an really promising innovation that can help lower costs for deploying wireless networks. And it's Open RAN Center for Integration and Deployment. But the problem is many of these networks were built with Huawei and ZTE equipment using legacy radio access network architectures. So providers in my state have been unable to replace their Huawei and ZTE equipment because of the delays in funding rip and replace. So now they're rationing the remaining parts they need to repair their equipment, and they tell me that it's just constantly at risk. It's what we used to call, you know, you baling wire things together, and it's really problematic. Thanks for asking.
Well, thank you.